class, welcome to week one of U.S. History 1302. I'm Emily Green, I'm your instructor for the course, and this week I am filming a short video in front of the U.S. Capitol building that you can see behind me. I am standing on the front lawn in front of the U.S. Capitol building, and there are some protesters behind me that you'll be able to see and probably hear, because they've got their megaphones out. They're loud, of course. So this week, you guys are going to be focusing or reading on capital and labor, where you'll go over the labor and populist movements, the rise of inequality in America, and 19th century socialism. You guys are also going to be talking about the Indian Wars and railroads and economic expansion as you guys read about conquering the West. Now behind me, the Capitol building is home to the legislative branch of the government. So you have Congress there, the Senate, and the U.S. House of Representatives. This is where laws are made. During the time that you guys are reading about, the president had a lot less power than what they do today. A lot of the things that you'll be reading about happened, or laws were passed, because of the building behind me, because of the people there, not specifically because of the president. The president's power greatly expanded, or the power of the executive branch greatly expanded under Theodore Roosevelt and Woodrow Wilson, and then it expanded even more during the Great Depression and World War II under Franklin Roosevelt, under FDR. Today, the presidency is much more powerful than anyone ever imagined in the 1700s. In the late 1800s, in the time period that you're reading about, Congress passed legislation and created laws that impacted the labor movement and Manifest Destiny, which led to the modern era, which is why I thought it would be appropriate to film here in front of where those laws were passed. Now this week, you guys, it's your first week, so you have your discussion one to turn in along with your quiz one. Now to gain access to the quiz, remember that you do have to complete the BioSig verification, so don't forget to do that in order to get access to the quiz. And then you'll also want to go ahead and review the requirements for your journals and start those. If you write 2 to 3 journal entries a week, then the week that it's due, you guys will be able to just submit it and be done with it. You won't have to write all 10 in a matter of a couple of days. So it's a good practice to go ahead and get a jump start on those. You'll also want to read the requirements for your essay and start to think about topics for that, and then start your research. That's due week 6, and that comes pretty fast. So start that now. If you're having trouble coming up with a topic for your essay, under the essay link and the page with the requirements, there will be a link there to some suggested topics and some questions to kind of help you guys figure out what you want to do. Now, if you have any questions about the journal, the essay, any requirements for the course, any weekly assignments, anything in general that you have questions or concerns about, please email me, please reach out to me. I'm here to help you guys throughout this course. I want you to succeed, so please do not hesitate to email me or message me if you have any questions or concerns about anything. I look forward to a wonderful 8-week course with you guys, and best of luck.